not moving right now. I'm lagging.
Oh, yeah. All right, guys, welcome back. All three of us are here. Brad might sound a little muted. We all got the strawberry e-juice. Me and Jesse actually suggested this back when Matt was still brewing there, and him and Tony said it would be almost impossible. So let's see how the impossible tastes. Smell a strawberry.
I don't smell strawberry either.
Yeah, Brad, you're gonna have to get like right up on your phone.
I don't smell strawberry either.
That actually sounded good.
It's gotta be something with the threesome thing.
Yeah. It just smells like a.
So you're quite a threesome?
Yeah. It smells almost like just like an apricot IPA. It's about it.
Pretty much.
Yeah, I don't get any strawberry.
A little bit of fruitiness, but not strawberry.
And this was canned 424, and it's, what, 5.3
now?
5.3 now. Yeah, let's get into it.
I mean, it's alright, but I don't taste strawberry.
No, I mean, at least they stepped away from the typical raspberry, blueberry, blackberry like they always do.
Man, I was really hoping to be able to taste strawberry.
They need to do like a honeydew. Or cantaloupe.
I think either one of those is probably going to be about like this is. They're not like a super flavorful fruit that's going to be hard to get the taste out of, I would think.
But I mean, the typical, you know, like everything they got on the picture, raspberry, blackberry, pineapple, mango. I mean, that shit's all played out.
Those are mainly strong flavors, though.
Yeah.
Things like the honeydew, cantaloupe, something like that, eating it, the fruit itself isn't really that strong of a flavor, let alone try to make it in the beer.
I don't want them to start doing a whole bunch of artificial additives and shit, because then it just starts tasting like beer with a Jolly Rancher in it.
Besides not tasting strawberry, I mean, it's good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's good for an e-juice. I mean, I don't think there's ever been an e-juice that I didn't like.
I just wouldn't get this one.
Yeah, this is definitely one of the lower ones that I've had.
I guess just basically whatever hops that they used, if they make this again, they need to cut those hops in half.
I was really excited about this one too.
Yeah.
I was really hoping that good strawberry flavor to come through.
This is one of the first beers from Rough Tail that I've bought in quite a while.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think the only thing I've got since The only thing I got since Matt left, I think, was this, the Blackberry e-juice. I don't know who did the adaptation 14. I don't think it was Matt. I think it was like right after he left. And that Mosaic milkshake. Like, I didn't bother going to their anniversary party. I mean, I don't want to air the dirty laundry, but there's a few people that can suck my cock that work there. But they can suck it on White History Month, I'll tell you that.
Jesse, you missed out on the first half of this video. Steven offered to do butt stuff with the internet guy to get it fixed.
I just actually hit the mute button on the phone. He's like, yeah, let me look into that modem problem for you. I said, yeah, if you can't get it fixed, maybe you can come over. We can do some butt stuff. And the thing is, the guy...
Come entertain me, Jose.
Yeah, his name was Jose. And, like, literally, Vive is, like, half a mile, a third of a mile or so away from here.
Yeah,
you just took your tripod and set up in front of the building. That way you had internet.
Shit.
Yeah, because they're right there across the street from YMCA.
Mm-hmm. You know, butt stuff, YMCA, it goes dick and butt, you know. I mean, this is okay, but if you're watching this and you're trying to decide if you're going to buy this, don't do it. Save your $12 to $15 or whatever it is you're going to pay for it.
For the price, there's a lot more along these lines that's better for the price.
Yeah, get if you want strawberry, get the strawberry blonde from Nothing Left. They're up out of Tulsa.
I don't know what I paid for my single. You know how the fucking Josh guy is, not goddamn pricing his cans.
Bastard. So what do you get out of it, Brad?
I honestly don't know what it is that I'm tasting. Like, what the fruit is. It's definitely not a strawberry.
I'm just getting the hops. They used, you know...
That's got to be what it is. It's just whatever they hopped it with.
Yeah, it's just overpowering it. Jesse?
It's a good beer, but it's not what they say it is.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So what do you think?
I'm trying to pinpoint the different things I'm tasting, but I just can't really pinpoint any one thing.
I can't either. I don't know what the fucking taste is that I'm getting. It's got to be the hops.
It's like you took had some mango and dropped it in the grass or in the dirt and ate it. That's about it.
About made Brad go.
It came out my nose just a little bit.
So if you're watching this, I have a third of a can of the strawberry e-juice for sale for $2.50. It'll be on the front porch. Just leave the money in the mailbox. Yeah. All right, so me and Jesse will spin. Brad, you go first, and then I'll go, and then Jesse goes. Okay, Jesse.
All right. I don't know. 7, 8, somewhere near.
I said six. So you're getting about an overall 7, and that's you got to be thanking the Jesus that you fucking worship. You're getting that high of a score.
Yeah, there's just no strawberry. That's what fucking killed it for me.
Yep.
If they didn't, like, tell you, like, it wasn't stamped strawberry on the bottom of the can, it would have been a higher score because it's a decent beer.
Yeah.
But,
yeah,
there's no strawberry.
All right. So there you go. Sorry. First time we've done the three-way. What we might have to start doing is one of you two.
Your first three-way?
Yeah.
Well, we're gonna have to... guys.
Hey. What we're probably going to start doing the next time is you two start up and then invite me, and then we can kind of test it to see how the loud, the, you know, because, yeah, it doesn't matter how loud I am. Yeah. All right, we'll be seeing you.